Can I ask this? How are you expecting me to take it?
To be honest, I knew that I was bisexual, and even if you took it badly, I was prepared to just carry on with my life anyways. Because for me, I wanted to be fully happy. I've never asked you openly how you felt about it, because I was prepared just to live my life anyway. And if that meant cutting everyone out of my life so I could be genuinely happy, I was gonna do it.
My name is Mahe and I am a student and I work as a quantity surveyor. I grew up in a little suburb in Auckland called Glenelis, and I now live in Mount Maunganui. My dad's from Tonga, and he's from a village called Leimatua and Matahau.
8 years ago, I had broken up with my then girlfriend. I knew then and there that I was bisexual. I told my dad in the driveway of his old house, and then he just looked at me and was just like, it's all good, I understand. But I'm unsure if he fully understands. I believe he thinks I can change it.
He would have been struggling to tell me because he knows basically, like, I really try to be like a man's man, you know? Play rugby, do stuff. Most of the guys I know hang out with, the tough guys. I think he was struggling with that part to be able to share with me. I'd rather accept him to feel comfortable in who he is than to force him into something else he's not. When I was born, so I was over the moon. I was also quite young. Seeing probably not the best parts or sides of my father, it kind of made me think about how I want to be with Mahe. When I parted ways with his mum, my mother took a big part of raising him.
Being raised by my grandmother gave me a sense of stability and felt secure and loved. That's what I wanted the most, and I got that from her. She worked very hard, very loving, very caring, made sure that I was looked after, pushed me hard to get educated and wanted me to get educated and make a better life for myself. That's where I get my drive to succeed is from her. She taught me everything that I know now. I saw an opportunity with the demand for quantity surveyors in the construction industry, and I followed the demand, and that's why I'm here now. Working part-time as a QS really has helped me.
I remember stories from Naima when they came here. Even buying bread and milk was difficult, like, because they didn't know how to speak English. It actually really upsets me a lot, because knowing what she was like and then going into a shop and then having to struggle to ask for bread and milk, it beats me up, eh?
Yeah. I think the context of the struggle is in Tonga, when you go to the shops, the bread looks different.
Oh yeah, definitely. Well, they say it all the time. Tonga is way better.
Yeah, the bread looks different, and so does the milk. But also too, we can go to the shop and say, we can say to the shopkeeper, I'll be back tomorrow, back on the next day to pay for the bread, and it's okay.
Yeah.
But in New Zealand, you need to be able to work to get money.
Oh, 100%.
And you'd be guaranteed that when they came here, no one took them around the shop and go, this is how we do shopping.
Yeah, exactly.
It's what you pick out, this is bread.
I don't really fit in the queer community, and I don't really fit in the straight world. I think that people's position on bisexuality is that you have a choice, and it still feels that way. But you can't help who you fall in love with. You can't help that fact, and that's what you don't choose.
Cool. We're currently just down at the site of what was the Rainbow Youth Drop-In Centre in Tauranga. They don't know yet, but suspected arson, someone burnt it down. Although, like, I didn't come here, it's sad to think that this is possibly an attack on the community that I'm a part of, you know? just makes you think, why are we so behind? Why are we not progressing? The thought of it really pisses me off. It made me think myself, I don't do enough for the community. Even though I feel like I've had a rough time trying to fit in, it doesn't mean that I still can't help. I might reach out and just see what I can do. I feel like someone might see that I'm doing something and take inspiration to then help as well.
For me, the biggest thing is just to have you as a dad there all the time. Because obviously for me, growing up with my grandmother, even though I love her, I never had parents, I just had her. And she did all the things that a dad was supposed to do with me. I guess it's hard because I know you were going through your own stuff and you got remarried and stuff like that. Things that I see you do with Uppy and Fort in Kingston, like I never had that. And I struggle with that. But I see that you are a good dad to them and that makes me happy.
I don't know if I have what it is to be a father.
None of us are going to be great dads. We become great dads, and that's the key word, we become. You can prepare yourself to be a great dad, but some of the stuff that we prepare for in life isn't what we're going to ever use. I don't see a certificate saying, you got a diploma to be a dad.
Yeah.
And some of the knowledge that we use and study for, we'll never be able to use in the real life.
You've obviously become a great dad because you have all these things you can lecture me on now.
Yeah, just imagine that. Just imagine the scrapes and the cuts that I bear to be able to get there. I sit there and think about, what would you become if I didn't make the choices I made back then?
I just want to say I love you, Dad. And thank you for doing this. It means a lot to me.